Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. Today, we continue our series of reports on the latest scientific papers from the ESA's Rosetta mission to Comet 67P. In the previous episode, Dr. Franklin Anariba discussed the direct measurement of electrical activity near the comet nucleus, data which may eventually prove to be a game changer in comet science. Today, Dr. Anariba, a specialist in electrochemistry, continues his analysis, which suggests that electrochemical reactions play a fundamental role in much comet activity.
In episode 2 of this series, I expand on the presence of electrical activity in the vicinity of the nucleus of comet 67P. This is done by commenting on two important recent reports. In the manuscript titled, The Rosetta Ion and Electron Sensor, IES, Measurement of the Development of Pickup Ions from Comet 67P, Churyumov-Gerasimenko by Gosson et al., the plasma environment is scrutinized at a heliocentric distance of 3.5 astronomical units and at 28 kilometers from the nucleus of the comet. In summary, the authors report, 1. Detection of low-energy water cation population for the first time in a weakly outgassing comet far from the sun. 2. Water cation populations detected display 10 varying distributions. 3. No angular distribution is observed for the water cation populations, suggesting that these ions are created locally and have not been accelerated by the solar wind electric field as suspected with mass loading. 4. Interestingly, mass loaded ions and solar wind protons move in opposite direction, while electrons remain unaffected. The implications of these findings reside on the assumptions that mass loading plays an important role at such large heliocentric distances on a comet with a tenuous Comet density. For instance, it has been reported that the solar wind ions are deflected but not slowed down as expected during a mass loading process, suggesting that mass loading is negligible. Therefore, these findings instead can be interpreted to indicate a complex and dynamical electron rich environment near the nucleus at such large heliocentric distances where mass loading is negligible, suggesting another ion motion mechanism is dominant. In this line of thinking, of utmost interest is the paper by Clark et al. Titled Supra-thermal Electron Environment of Comet 67P, Churyumov-Gerasimenko, Observations from the Rosetta Ion and Electron Sensor. The term supra-thermal implies highly heated electrons possessing high kinetic energy. In the manuscript, according to the authors, supra-thermal fast-moving electrons are accelerated by unknown mechanism from a few electron volts upwards to hundreds of electron volts and play an important role in the electron-neutral chemistry as well as the dust grain charging. Moreover, previous studies show that these accelerated electrons are ubiquitous, but could not agree on a particular mechanism. Several accelerating electron mechanisms have been put forth. 1. Supra-thermal electrons are likely associated with upstream cyclotron wave fluctuations convecting tailwards. In other words, the accelerating energy is provided by mass-loaded ions traveling from the direction of the sun towards the tail of the coma. 2. Supra-thermal electrons are accelerated in a similar manner as electrons behind interplanetary collisionless bow shocks. 3. The active magnetospheric particle trace explorer satellite showed that lower hybrid cyclotron waves from mass-loaded ions were responsible for the electrons. Hybrid refers to cyclotron frequencies in between a proton and an electron. Some studies ascribe supra-thermal electron acceleration to photoionization, while other studies indicate the role of photoionization to be negligible. It is then clear that there is no agreement on the dominant mechanism behind supra-thermal electron acceleration, more so for Comet 67P, which has a 100 times lower Comet density than Comet Halley. In this context, the authors inform, 1. A highly dynamical supra-thermal electron cloud consistent with observations of peak comet activity near one astronomical unit. The authors add, it is surprising that a weakly outgassing comet at a large heliocentric distance produces a dynamic and energetic superthermal electron environment. Two, electron densities near the nucleus are in a ratio of 10 to 100 per centimeter cubic. Taking into consideration that the comet 67P was approximately 3 astronomical units at the time of the observations and displayed a tenuous coma, which contradicts all previous expectations, it is very likely that another mechanism for accelerating electrons near the nucleus is in action. The report continues on considering potential mechanisms for which processes account for the density and flux enhancement that the ion and electron sensor observes are not obvious. For instance, one, photoelectrons play a role by ionizing molecules and creating energetic secondary ions via photoelectron impact dissociation. Two, ambipolar electric field. The authors comment that, open quote, if a well-structured electric field were present, then a well-defined peak would be expected. Again, this points to a fine structure in the plasma environment. End of quote. The implications are that the electric field is filamentary in nature. Three, acceleration caused by cross-shock potentials. Interesting enough, a cross-shock potential, which has been observed to accelerate electrons, can be thought of as a double layer in an electrochemical experiment. However, there's no evidence for a bow shock or a reverse bow shock at a heliocentric distance of 3.5 astronomical units. Four, magnetic field compression. However, there was no data on the direction and magnitude of the solar wind associated magnetic field. Five, lower hybrid cyclotron waves due to mass-loaded ions. The authors settled for this explanation to explain their data. Surprisingly, the authors conclude that the superthermal electrons are being accelerated by an admixture of photoelectrons and cyclotron waves produced by pickup or mass-loaded ion instability. Their conclusion is contradictory because in the text, the authors report on a rich and dynamic electron cloud, indicating a high density of electrons in the vicinity of the nucleus, even though comet 67P displays a tenuous coma density. Hence, the question is, where are the electrons coming from? Another contradiction is that mass loading associated with the solar wind means speed deceleration. However, the authors state that, an open quote, the ion data do not show a significant deceleration of the solar wind, close quote, suggesting that ion mass loading by the solar wind is negligible. In addition, the authors write that, open quote, unfortunately, there's no instrument on board Rosetta that can measure electromagnetic waves at this frequency, close quote, referring to lower hybrid cyclotron frequencies. These observations might indicate that their conclusion is premature. From an electrical perspective, electron acceleration is due to a point charge sitting on an electric field, which is an indication of the presence of a voltage differential.
For continuous updates on space news from the electric universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.